Hi everyone, and welcome to this talk about everything you need to build a modern crossplay enabled game. First of all, as a quick introduction, I'm Simon Allaeys, and I'm a senior director on Epic Online Services. My everyday is focused on the mission behind Epic Online Services, which is to connect all players with our friends on any platform and any game. Now today, in the first part of this talk, I'll be covering why crossplay matters to you as a game developer. Then I'm joined by my colleagues, George Markiewicz and Don Eubanks, who will take a more technical dive into the different components Epic Online Services provides and into the future of these services. Diving in, first of all, as an industry, we have many ways of defining what is cross-platform versus cross-play versus cross-progression versus cross-save. But as a player myself, you know, none of this taxonomy really matters. What you really want is to just be able to log in with one account regardless of platform. You want to access your save games or progression anywhere. And most importantly, you want to just simply connect with your friends no matter what device or platform they or you are on. You just want to have a great time. And this is really cross-platform or cross-play in a nutshell. And as an industry or as a game developer, why does this matter? We have some case studies from Fortnite. You know, if you look back to the early days of Fortnite, we observed a peculiar thing. Each time we added a new platform, not only did that bring in new players from that new platform, but we also witnessed a lift of new players and increased engagement across all other platforms. And when we look back to the Fortnite's first season of Chapter 2, we introduced a new game mechanic, fishing. And again, we observed something interesting. This fishing really split the community. And this was something we hadn't seen before. Some players loved fishing, while some hated fishing. But what we noticed is that it wasn't just individuals who either liked or disliked fishing. It was an actual split in the social graph, which reflected the preferences of entire groups of friends rather than just individuals. And this inspired us to dig further into how a player's preferences are reflected on their friends. And it turns out engagement for you as a player has a high correlation with the engagement of your friends. When we cohort to the engaged players, who in this study play more than 50 rounds of Fortnite a month, there's a big difference in likelihood of churn when you play alone versus with friends. If nearly all of those 50 plus games are played with friends, you're 80% less likely to churn than if you were to play all of those games alone. And even if you just play a few of those games with a friend, you're already 50% less likely to churn. We also see patterns in spending. If you spend $50 in game, it's 8% more likely your close friends will spend $50 in the game. And if you started to enjoy the game less and were to move 50% closer to churning, that also means that all of your close friends would move 9% closer to churn on average. And now you might be wondering, as a talk about crossplay, what's all this emphasis on friendships and games? But if we take a brief look back in history, friendships have always been a big part of gaming. From going to arcades to buying your first gaming device and sitting on the couch with friends, to then becoming online connected, to going mobile, and eventually to almost be living online in virtual worlds. Friendships are a big part of gaming. And if you look at today's 2.9 billion gamers worldwide, many are connected to the internet, but we do still find friends siloed in smaller ecosystems. And this is where crossplay comes in. Crossplay is critical to helping keeping friends connected, regardless of the devices they own. And when we look at more numbers, the impact of crossplay is clear on not just Fortnite, but also when we cross-reference these trends in Rocket League. It's clear that crossplay and engagement are closely connected. Across both games, we find that more than half of all players play with their friends who are playing on a different platform, and those who crossplay with their friends across different platforms play more days each week, and they play more hours each day. And they are far more likely to spend something in the game. And as we said in previous slides, all of this is contagious across friend groups. And this in itself represents an enormous opportunity for the industry. We can only imagine what industry growth might look like if we were to remove all barriers between friends, if we were to let all players play together with all of their friends. Our experiences with crossplay on both Fortnite and Rocket League have without a doubt told us that connecting all platforms and all friends will provide the next big growth spurt for gaming. And this may very well take us from today's 2.9 billion gamers to the next 2 billion. And that's why we believe crossplay matters, and why we believe crossplay should be the new status quo. And with this, I'd like to hand it over to Josh to talk about what we've been building with Epic Online Services in order to help all developers achieve this goal. Thank you.
Thanks, Simon. Hi, I'm Josh Markiewicz, the lead programmer for the EOS Client SDK here at Epic Games. I've assisted with the online experience since Unreal Tournament 3, improved Gears of War experience by adding dedicated servers, and helped bring cross-platform play to Paragon, where we learned quite a bit about matchmaking, scalability, and running a live product. I've been a part of the journey to scale Fortnite to millions of players. Crossplay can seem daunting at first. Fortnite took years of trial and error. So let's try to simplify it and give it a checklist. We'll purely focus on the technical components in this section. There are a lot of business requirements and approvals, but we'll leave those can of worms at the door for now. Taking it from the top, we'd like to break down our components of a crossplay online infrastructure into game services and account services. Each platform delivers its own proprietary backend systems. These, however, are not compatible with all platforms. As a developer, you're going to need to integrate and manage these services for each platform separately, build your own set of platform independent services, or use Epic Online Services. They also come with specific account requirements and don't work across platforms. This is the crux of the problem. It's what defines the platform boundaries for players and prevents crossplay with friends in your games. As a game dev, you're going to need to solve for these platform independent game services and cross-platform account services components for your game to be truly cross-platform. We began implementing these things in Paragon. Over time, we added most systems in one form or another. Then with Fortnite, things exploded and we had to deal with scale. We had back-end teams and client-side teams working together to create the best systems within the limitations of that scale. Let's start with game services. With Epic Online Services, we provide services for you to ship on any platform. Foundationally, all of these services work with any account system, OpenID or otherwise. They are open and modular, and we operate them for you. These are the vertical slices meant to stand on their own. We're going to look a little deeper at each of these services, what they are, how they work, and why you need them. Starting with multiplayer, we have matchmaking, which is a cross-platform pool of players, and it's basic bookkeeping for what servers are doing and where they can be found. We have lobbies, their data relay service for a group of players. It's a part of matchmaking, but with a persistent connection hosted by a backend that players connect with. Attributes can be stored in the lobby and for each individual user long before they're connected to each other. There's peer-to-peer networking. It's often forgotten just how much firewalls can restrict your player base. This means players are unable to host matches, causing friction and confusion early in the game. Peer-to-peer provides a way to negotiate how players can connect with each other and offers a relay solution when players can't talk directly. Additionally, some platforms have cert requirements here for security reasons. There's progression. We have standard features like cloud storage, reading and writing stats, achievements, and leaderboards. Again, all platform agnostic. There's inventory, which is a game-specific data schema hosted on the back end. It works with various storefronts to provide secure receipt validation and fulfillment of offers based on an item catalog. Then there's account linking. That's an important one to notice. Think of account linking as a key ring you can attach various identity providers to. Without it, progression is locked to a single platform. Epic Online Services by design is completely account agnostic and supports many providers already. Each platform can be recognized in the key ring, so progression is shared wherever you go. There's moderation. For example, anti-cheat. Popular PC games traditionally attract people looking to get an advantage, and console players have a certain level and expectation of trust in their games. So in 2018, we acquired industry-leading Easy Anti-Cheat, and we offer that for free now. The goal, of course, is to maintain fair play across all platforms. Player reporting and sanctions reach across platform boundaries to keep you aware of problems in your community and keep your ecosystem healthy. And finally, there's operations. Title storage is a common data controlled by the dev. All game clients can retrieve it and allow you to dynamically change your live product anytime you want. Game analytics and telemetry allow you to monitor various aspects of your game in real time. So say you now have a cross-platform game backend, be it with the game services and Epic Online Services or your own proprietary services, and you've now committed to building a cross-platform game. You'll need to enable your players to log in across available platforms. And when it comes to account linking, have an agnostic account provider act as a Rosetta Stone of sorts. Using a common UX, it should be transparent to users that they are linking the account and they only have to do it once. From that point forward, this account provides an external mapping to reach other linked platforms. Additionally, having a common profile makes it clear to your friends who you are no matter what platform you play on, and having some account management provide transparent views into what connections have been made. All this is done using the existing secure standards implemented by the various other identity providers. Building on top of an individual identity, players branch out and create their own social graph. You have your friends list, a social graph with aggregation across platforms, and now your players are connected. One list with all the platforms, so your interactions exist in one place. It integrates with the native platforms. We aren't trying to create a social graph, we're simply connecting existing ones. And now you need to help them connect to see each other, get them communicating. With presence and invites across platforms, anyone can join in on the fun. You need parties to keep players together. What's the social circle going to be doing for the evening so they can coordinate play even when they're not in the same game? This all serves to increase engagement. Our social overlay strives to keep this in a common, easy-to-use view across games and platforms. The goal is to handle complicated flows and provide a UX that engages the player within the game. Thanks to all the devs using Epic Online Services, it's been a great journey so far. We've come a long way since our online experience with Gears of War, and it's exciting to take what we've learned with Fortnite and provide it to the entire game development community. Our goal is to make EOS easy and accessible for all. The SDK is designed to be available for all engines and should integrate simply, making it accessible to different types of games, genres, and stores. It's already shipping on these different platforms. You can mix and match the features you need. So, bringing it all together. On the left, we've discussed everything you need to do services for your game. You write it once, you ship it everywhere. You get the freedom to ship anywhere, anytime, prepare for and empower yourself with a cross-store world. As mentioned in an early slide, even adding one platform provides lifts to all platforms. It's your choice and independence as a dev. On the right is everything you need to enable and expand your community, one connected player base. Players have frictionless access and the ability to reach their friends. Therefore, the community stays connected, and that's what it is. It's about enabling the community. We believe this connectivity truly helps the industry and gamers at large. We've always wanted to do this, and we want to share it. We think it's really powerful, and we hope you'll agree. Always keep your friends connected, no matter what game they feel like playing on any given day, or whatever platform they feel like playing on. There's still lots of service to build, and we're not finished. The industry's changed a lot since online services were first introduced. We've come a long way and hope to continue its evolution. Here's Don to talk about the road ahead.
Hi, I'm Don Eubanks. I worked on social systems and features for Fortnite, and I'm now one of the lead programmers for the EOS SDK team. As Josh said, I'm here to talk about the road ahead for Epic Online Services. To be clear, the word road here is not accidental. What I'm laying out is a road map. You heard Josh talk about some of our existing success stories, and those successes and feedback from industry developers have helped us build this roadmap to ensure we'll continue meeting the most important needs for a wide variety of developers and titles. Josh gave you a glimpse into inventory, which is built for any developer who wants to be able to offer reliable item fulfillment and storage. With it, you can get reliable cross-progression using architecture similar to that which powers Fortnite. Also coming is our custom game invite system. This is meant specifically for developers and games that already have their own matchmaking session or lobby solution. It allows those games to integrate cleanly and smoothly with our social UI and reap the benefits of that without having to migrate to an EOS offering. Now earlier Simon talked about what we discovered with Fortnite, and if there's any main idea you take away today, it should be that crossplay propels engagement. If you can find ways to support more platforms, more friends can participate, and fewer friends end up being left out. For us, that means a big part of the road ahead is social. The backbone of all our social offerings is Epic Account Services. Epic Account Services is the same social ecosystem players know from their experiences in Fortnite, Rocket League, and the Epic Games Store. A point of pride for us is that all the game services we offer work no matter what underlying social system you're building on. Your players don't need to be logged in with or even have accounts on Epic Account Services for you to execute your game's vision across all platforms. That being said, Josh discussed some of the challenges we faced and we know other developers have faced trying to build a cross-platform product, especially a multiplayer one, without a thriving cross-platform social ecosystem to bring players together. As you know, we already support seeing what friends are playing through our presence service. Soon that presence will be viewable with full localization support. We'll also be offering players the ability to party up with their friends for play sessions, and we want to minimize the amount of heavy lifting players need to do in order to get together. Parties make it easy to create and maintain cross-platform communication and connection, no matter what game everyone is playing. We're also looking at ways to allow developers to build their game's concept of clans, guilds, and communities in general with configurable groups. You've already seen examples of our social overlay through many of the titles released on PC. This overlay is going to be coming to even more platforms, so developers can trivially benefit from a vibrant and evolving social interface without having to build it themselves that's consistent across platforms. Now that we've talked about social, let's talk identity. In our cross-platform future, it's more important than ever to make sure that you have a consistent way for your friends to recognize you, regardless of what platform you're playing on. Profile information and avatars are a few of the new features on our list to help users identify and express themselves. We also want to ensure players have full control over the information they share. Along with enhanced identity features, we're designing equally thorough privacy controls that will let players control who can find them in search, as well as protect and limit exposure of platform identities. It's important for developers today to have a good understanding of their audience and be able to make sure that they're taking all the necessary steps to protect the parts of their audience that need parental consent in order to play in their country. Epic Online Services will be offering tools for developers to set up their own verified parental consent flows. These are the same industry-leading tools provided by SuperAwesome and are already in use by some of the largest titles in the world. These tools and services are not only free of charge, but the parental verifications themselves will also be performed at no cost to developers. Like I said in the beginning, this is a roadmap. Specific details can change, but I hope you get a sense of the direction we have and of our firm resolve to continue providing top-notch software and services. The question we often get asked is, why is Epic doing all of this? And there's two major reasons. The first is that we want there to be a decentralized set of services for game development. Having an interconnected, not a siloed, audience means everyone wins. This is why so many of our offerings are a la carte. We want developers to be able to mix and match the specific tools and services that are appropriate for their titles, and we want to help drive the creation of open industry standards for the long term. The second reason is that we want to scale the industry into what we feel is its next major growth phase. This means accelerating the adoption and prevalence of cross-platform gaming and the vibrant communities that result. And we've seen firsthand how that helps players build and maintain close friendships that persist across game sessions and experiences. Speaking of scale, another goal is to let developers shoot for the stars with their designs, with the confidence that their title will handle the best kind of problem to have: massive amounts of traffic and attention. We know that supporting even basic crossplay and cross-progression are tough problems, and until recently they've only been available to companies that have the ability to invest in persistent, purpose-built back-end infrastructure, which often limited it to games as a service. With Epic Online Services, we're making the tough problems easier, but keeping the easy things easy. But I suppose why is Epic doing this is only part of the question we get asked. The full question is, why is Epic doing this for free? Epic Online Services are available completely free of charge. They're free of charge because we want these services to be available and accessible for any and all developers with the fairest possible terms. And the fairest possible terms are completely free of charge. If those sound like fair terms to you as well, you can get started now. As a reminder, it's free. Actually free. 100% free. The SDK is built to support your title regardless of engine, store, or platform. We've built extensive tooling for self-service and configuration to ensure you're always in control of your title's functionality. We've built our monitoring tools using the collective wisdom of our tough-as-nails Fortnite LiveOps veterans. That being said, you're not on your own either. You'll also have access to support from both Epic and the EOS community at large.